Hello everyone and welcome back to another episode of Subnautica. We are continuing off from last time where we basically did a base survey of the area and I believe we built our vehicle bay. So I took the time in between episodes to go gather some materials, and today we will be building the Sea Moth and using that to explore to find a good spot for our base. First things first though, we have a communications relay to listen to.
This is an automated bounce back from the Aurora mining vessel. Your distress signal has been received. An emergency relief team will be dispatched to your location. The estimated arrival time, 9:00 hours.
Goal, holy death. Okay. Whoa! We're not getting rescued anytime soon, so it's up to us to survive going forward. Let's go ahead and, let's see, do I have the items on me? Nope, don't think so. We're gonna go ahead and build the Sea Moth. As I said, I gathered the necessary items off camera, so you guys didn't have to swim around in a big loop with me. Let's hop in. Climb up here. Let's see what we get. So, Sea Moth, go little drones, go. Build me that wonderful little thing. Of course, we'll be taking name suggestions for the Sea Moth, though we don't have a moon pool just yet to name it. Let's go ahead and hop inside. Captain. Thank you. So yeah, the Sea Moth, first real vehicle that you really get in the game. And it's going to allow us to travel much farther, much quicker. And we'll go ahead and scout a good place to call home. First things first. I think I need some food. That I do. And we need to grab some water real quick. So let's find an air sac fish. Not seeing one too close to base. Let's quickly jet over here. Here's one right there. Okay, I got one. I'm probably gonna need two. And that one zipped by too fast a click. There we go. Alright, so water acquired. And I guess we can either head to the island to go gather some research material and maybe some seeds for base building so we don't have to really worry about food anymore. So let's go ahead, cook up this. And by cook, I mean, I guess, distill some water. Like so, and boop, boop. Alright. So, that should be enough to make it to the island. And the island is pretty much directly this direction. Might be slightly off, but we'll just head off and see if we can find it or not. As we creep over these vines here. Oh, there's some of those whale creatures who I always forget their names, but the sounds are just really wonderful in this game, as always. Gonna get a little bit of lag as we generate the terrain out here. Fairly normal kind of stuff. As unless you go somewhere, it doesn't really bother rendering in anything. And kind of look around. Alright, yeah, there's some definitely deep areas over in this direction. Not really seeing any sign of the island just yet. But it's usually just as we lose sight of the Aurora. So there's the Aurora kind of fading off in the distance. Don't know why it fades off so soon. It always kind of bugged me that a cloud just happens to roll in around the Aurora. I think it would be pretty cool to be able to see off a long ways. And it looks like we have found the island over here. Yep, this is the island. So we'll get closer. We'll go ahead, hop on the shore, gather up, and scan some materials that'll help us form our base. And We'll go ahead and maybe find some locations for our base. One, of course, building on the island. There are some downsides in doing so. You are a good ways away from basic materials such as titanium and copper, which you need for a decent amount of electronics. A scannable module. That's new to me. I don't think I've ever... Scanner room fragment. So we'll just scan this thing up. Okay, now the scanner room, I think, is something that I haven't built yet. So there's four pieces of it. We have piece number one. Don't need my dive reel or anything. So we don't have much inventory. So let's go ahead and find some stuff that we need. Don't need any of these trees. At least not at this time. And I can always come back to scan this stuff. I need to find those melons. And then also the tree that gives the best food in the game. I think it's up there on the mountaintop. It's always a little annoying to traverse this island. The pathways are never very clear. I think we can... Nope. Nope. Gotta go up. Can't go down. Let's try over here. Quickly, quickly. So yeah, there are three kind of wrecked habitats around on this island. And they do give a clue as to what might have happened here. So we need an exterior grow bed. This is good to be scanning. A Chinese potato plant. I've never seen this thing before. It's not giving us seeds. It's probably one of those harvestable things that you had to plant. Alright, so let's see. We have some marble melon and some seeds now for that. I probably shouldn't have kept attacking that potato plant. That's a scannable object here. This is a spotlight, which you can attach to your structure, and it will kind of just scan around a little bit and provide a little bit of light. Though it does drain a lot of battery.
New blueprint acquired.
Acquired. Okay, let's see here. I think getting in this thing was always a little bit of a pain. Oh, a living wall. That's pretty cool. That's a nice decoration for our base. So yeah, we can either build around the last time, same spot, and build along the kind of the creep vines, or we can build something somewhere a little bit more interesting. Supply crate that decided to jump out at us. Let's head down here. Some more living walls. Another supply crate with a battery. Perfect. That can be useful. Okay, and PDA, Chief Executive Officer with the Torgalgen Corporation. My crew and I were marooned here 5 weeks ago when our ship was struck by some kind of weapon. We constructed a habitat using materials reclaimed from the ship. We survived by cultivating indigenous flora, the biochemistry imprint I commissioned. Blah, blah, already paid for itself. Now for her safety, a mercenary hired for the journey is increasingly disturbed. She insists we abandon the site and go underwater. Okay, well, that's where they went. Sabotage. Okay, nonetheless. Okay, so it looks like they went underwater after living here for a while. I don't know why. How unforgivable the ocean is, and abandon this foolish ambition. Okay, well, so like one of them is going slightly crazy or has plans of their own. Let's go this way and climb up here quickly, because I don't want to waste all my daylight, because once this place becomes dark, it becomes rather annoying to navigate through, so it'd be best if I either skip the nighttime or did this quickly enough. Oh, I can still see the aurora. Okay, that's nice. Let's see. Nothing useful on those plants. Just keep going up as best as possible. Okay, inside. So here is another one of those potatoes, which I can just take directly, I guess. Chinese potato. So it's a food and seed in one. We're gonna go ahead and grab this pot. And it looks like they harvest more than one. I don't know if they regrow automatically, kind of like the tree. I already got that. Let's go ahead and get a chair. A good commander always needs a good chair to sit in. Another PDA. Chair acquired. So we'll click on that. I don't know if it's going to give us any new information or not. Doesn't look like it. Okay, so now we just have to go to that side. Falling damage, still not a thing in the game, which I'm okay with. It kind of speeds up our travels across this landscape. Okay, becoming nighttime. Great, wonderful. Not what I wanted to see, but that's okay. Come on, up we go. Boy, navigating this stuff is always just a little annoying. I really hope at some point they kind of smooth out the terrain up here. No, 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 no. Okay, well, yeah, you can see the movement on the actual surface isn't so well. Something I really wish they would change, or at least smooth out this island a little bit so you can actually navigate it. So let's go ahead. We can use the little sea moth here, or sea glide, I guess, as a little flashlight. Kind of get our way back up this hillside and climb back up to... I keep falling off the cliff. God, I am so bad at this. Tell you what, we're not gonna record nighttime, because that's terrible for YouTube. You guys won't be able to see anything. And so, tell you what, we're gonna go ahead and skip when we're back on top of the mountain. And would you guys just look at this sunset coming up over the horizon? We are up on top of the last spot. And went ahead and scanned pretty much everything here. We got the observation kind of pod here. We got the planter. We got some of the seeds from the plant in there. And looks like we're pretty much done here. So Pokemon Go, by the way, great for just waiting out day-night cycles. Best thing in the world. Let's go ahead and hop off this cliff like a little bit of like a crazy person here. Go ahead and swim through the air with our magical flippers. There we go. Perfect. Perfectly safe from harm. Alright, let's head over here. Hop back into the sea moth.
Welcome aboard, Captain.
And head back to base, because we're pretty much ready to start gathering items and materials. And a whole bunch of titanium to form our base foundation. Also some glass, of course. And we'll be able to set up a small base of operations, hopefully, somewhere. And this base of operations will be probably a little bit smaller than the last one. What I want to do is have this initial one for crafting. And it might be a room or two. And then from there, we'll go ahead and use that as a launching point to build a base in some of the underground deeper caves. And we'll use thermal for power in those areas. So let's quickly as possible, head back over here. See some of these wonderful little whale-like things. Well, it looks like we're coming across a wrecked section of the Aurora. We can quickly look over here. Hop out. We'll just go ahead and open that up. Oh wow, what do we have here? We got some desks, we have some chairs, already scanned that stuff. Some emergency beacons. I don't even know why I bothered opening the door. This looks like something familiar. Well, let's see what's deeper. I know a lot of these aren't full of anything.
Of oxygen remaining.
Looks like there's a weldable spot. We don't have a laser cutter, so we're going to have to kind of skip this place for now. Anything else to gather? Doesn't look like it. Okay. Man, your guys is like constant rumbling. Little creepy. Little creepy indeed. Also, besides just naming the Sea Moth, I'm sure you guys will also pick the wonderful colors. As long as it's not something too ridiculous, I do like to make things look nice. Oh, well, just ran over a fish. Alright, so we'll head over here. Drop off anything into our chest. And then worry about constructing the builder tool. So we'll drop off all of our food kind of seeds there. And back out. Let's go ahead and see what the build tool needs. A computer chip. So let's see. A table coral sample. I can do that. That's relatively easy. And that's just over here. So those red. The red coral. There it is. And boop, and boop. Okay, so we got enough of that. Head on back inside. Turn off the light so it doesn't drain our power. Tools. Electronics, I mean, computer chip. Here we go. And tools. Habitat builder. Cool. So we have that now. Here's all the stuff we can make. And of course, we're gonna have to start with the multipurpose room, which we need 6 titanium. Which I don't think we really have right now, but we can go gather quick enough. Let's go ahead and find pieces of the ship that are gonna break down. Okay, here's one. This gives us 4 titanium. Let's grab these air bubbles. All right. A little bit of oxygen on the way is always nice. Okay, hello stalkers, go away. Yes, I think that's what you're called. Is that what you're called? I can never remember. We have a med bay. I don't have to worry about taking too much damage. Here's another ship part and another metal scrap. And another metal scrap. So I think that's enough titanium for now. Head back over here. Using up pretty much all of our Sea Glide's power. This thing really drains the power away. I can't wait till we get the charging fins again. Let's go ahead. Make this all into titanium. Should get 12. And we'll go ahead and get some glass as well from the quartz. Now let's go ahead and make one more glass. There we go. So, initial base. Let's go ahead over here. Now, last time I built in that direction, let's go on the opposite side. See if there's any cool terrain elements for our wonderful launching point into the depths. So let's see. So we can either go pretty deep into the flatlands here, or possibly let's go this way. I'll have to see what this little scannable thing is. Unless that thing wants to kill me. Yes, it does. It's a proportion cannon. Don't have one of those yet, but let's go ahead and flee for a little bit. You know, building out here would be interesting, but a little dangerous for my liking. But this is definitely a different biome than last time. And as long as we keep a okay distance from those stingray-like things, we'll be okay. Oh, ow. Sorry. I didn't mean to. Okay, I completely crushed that. I didn't even know you could. Huh. Is that used for anything? I doubt it. Tell you what, this rock shelf here might be pretty cool. Except for it's surrounded by all these wonderful little sharks. That's pretty cool of a little hole. We're gonna need to build a beacon first. Just so we can find the base again after we're plop it down. So that's something I kind of overlooked initially. So I'll head back real quick. Get that built. Come on. Breach! Oh yeah. It's nice to have the Sea Moth. We can definitely travel good ways, and then once we get the moon pool, we'll be able to recharge it. It'll be a good time here in Chateau Uthris. Let's hop outside. Okay, beacon. Beacon. Okay, copper wire. Copper wire acquired. Deployables. Beacon. Just like that. 2 km of a life pod? Or habitat at all times? Nah, screw that. I'm not gonna follow that rule. Let's head back out into this direction. Ooh, tiny fish. Because keeping close to a good supply of titanium, copper, and also silver is just a good reason to kind of keep around the kelp area. Or at least a short drive from it. Some more wrecked ship parts. Let's see. Propulsion cannon fragment. Ow! Ow.
Welcome aboard, Captain.
Screw you, piranha. Fine, I'll leave. What a dick. So was it down here? Yeah, so this is where we will call home. Wherever this is home. Okay. So first things first. I don't want to be too close to those shark things, so let's go a little bit deeper. Just enough. I don't know why the game always has trouble rendering out these areas for me. Kinda wish I did it a little bit better. And we're just, you know, have just enough scary sounds. This is perfect to call home, I think. What is that? That's a giant something. That is a giant floating piece of the Aurora. That just happened to be perched on top of one of these mushroom things. Okay, we're looking at this real quick. Power transmitter. Cool. We're gonna need that eventually to run power. Anything on the inside? We have a picture frame. Can't scan it yet for some reason. The creepiest noise I've heard all game. And let's just kind of back out here for a portion, second. 30 seconds. You know what? Kind of reclaiming remaining. A piece of the Aurora might be a cool thing to do. So what if we built our base on these large pads here? I think that'd be pretty cool. Let's do that. Multi-purpose room. Okay. Well, you don't like that. So I might have to build a foundation. Okay, I can't float a foundation. Aw, I really wanted to build on those. Screw it, we'll build out of the base.
Caution, 30 seconds of oxygen
remaining.
It's
fine, we're fine. Okay, if I could just... Okay, we're not fine. We're not fine. Get out of my breath.
10 seconds of oxygen remaining.
Come on, up we go. Get back to the Sea Moth. Get back to the Sea Moth. Come on. Okay. Let's bring the Sea Moth closer. This time. I think this little grassy patch.
Caution. Passing safe depth.
Fuck safety. Alright. Multi-purpose room. Come on. Tell you what, we might have to see if that destroys one of these trees. Well, it takes out the root of it, and now we have this tree growing out the ceiling.
Caution, 30 seconds of oxygen remaining.
Hatch. Hatch, hatch, hatch. Go inside.
Emergency.
It has no power.
Oxygen remaining.
Where is it? Where is it? Where's the Sea Moth? Sea Moth? No! I died. Well, we're back inside. Okay. Where the heck is the Sea Moth at? Oh, there you are! You piece of crap! Okay, let's... I need silicone rubber. I don't have anything to generate power. I don't even have solar panels, I don't think. Nope, I do. Bioreactor, yes, yes! This will be our first...
30 seconds of oxygen remaining.
First structure. Perfect. Not active.
Emergency. 10 seconds of oxygen
remaining.
No, fuck off.
Stop drowning. Okay. We could have picked an easier spot to build our first base, but I think this is going great. Just great. Okay, let's head back down here. I need plant matter to power this thing. Don't have any. So it doesn't have to be plant matter. Can I use this coral, maybe? Let's hope for the best and see if that fungal sample works.
Caution, 30 seconds of oxygen remaining.
We have power!
Power restored. All primary systems online.
Great! Good to hear. So yeah, we can use these fungal samples as our power source. And as you can see, we have pretty much unlimited of it. All right. We are turning this around real quick. We'll just pop that all the way full. Great, so bioreactor online. And now at this point, let's go ahead. We need silicone rubber. And that requires going back to base. Well, tell you what, I'm gonna go ahead and maybe work on this a little bit between episodes. This has gone on long enough. We have a base. At least a location kind of picked out. Let's go ahead and drop our beacon so I can find our way back here. And deploy. Perfect. Edit beacon label. So, let's see, forward base.
Caution.
There we go.
Of oxygen remaining.
Yeah. I'm fine. So how fast do you think that, I don't know how fast this is. We're gonna have to test things out and I'll be back next time for, hopefully things will be a little bit more stable. Anyways, thank you guys so much for watching as always. If y'all enjoyed the episode, feel free to subscribe if you're new. Go ahead and hit that like button. Leave a comment down below on what you guys think and maybe what I should be working on next. Go ahead and check out my other videos if you haven't done so already. And until then, I'll try not to drown. So, see you guys next time.